that. He's impersonating the new Jets coach. What do you like on the show today, Amin?
Press conferences.
Dale, papi.
Easy Running Beer convinced you that this year will be different.
57 points last night. This guy is on an offensive tear of 30-point games. It's ugly basketball. It's hard to watch. Isolation basketball, but it's efficient basketball. It's productive basketball. I would just say to you, though, based on this question, have we forgotten that he went 1-for-17 from three, not but a couple of days ago in Orlando? And that's exactly what ended Houston's season last year against Golden State, not being able to make any threes. People will not believe that this guy will win in clutch moments until he actually does. That's the way it works sometimes with the sports fan who isn't willing to move off of his or her position.
Yeah, Dan, the funny thing is him being this superhuman in January, February, etc., is what makes him so human in April, May, and maybe June, is that he is spent. He's using all his energy to carry this team without Chris Paul and now without Clint Capella to some amount of success just to get to the playoffs. He's got nothing left at the end. But I got to ask you a question, Dan. Why do you think it's ugly basketball?
Oh, because I hate watching it, because it's dribble, 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 go get a foul.
Well, hold on. He crosses over people. We love crossovers. He shoots threes like Steph. We love that. He finishes through contact. He scored 57 points last night. It's only 17 given the free throw line. That means 40 points of actual basketball that apparently you don't like.
Well, this year is going to be very, very different. You know, they're going to lose to the Warriors in six instead of seven, maybe five, maybe four.
Maybe four. Yeah, okay.
That's right.
In the first round.
Was Duke's loss a big deal?
It hasn't happened in a long time where a number one Duke team, and certainly not one as talented as this, loses at home with the one seed. But even with Zion Williamson going for 35 points, if you go 9-for-43 from three-point land, it's going to be really hard to overcome. They played against Syracuse. The game went into overtime. They almost overcame it. It doesn't matter that this team loses one-game samples now. That'll eliminate you in March, and if they go 9-for-43 from three in March, they will be eliminated.
Yeah, I mean, we got to mention also Cam Reddish didn't play. Tyus Jones got hurt, left early. So it wasn't exactly like Duke at its full strength. But also, 9-for-43, hey, you want to give it to the big guy in the middle of the zone right there to catch and finish around the rim who's been killing the whole game? RJ Barrett, another hero ball type of performance in the loss. Remember the Gonzaga game where he just kept gunning and gunning and gunning? I wonder, I know that Mike Krzyzewski will publicly defend RJ Barrett's drive and desire to take the big shot, but in private, in the practice court, will they have a conversation, hey, pass the ball to our best player?
I do wonder about that because they might as well get used to that now by being in college. The stuff that happens in the NBA when someone else is getting the touches you think that you deserve. You just saw it the other day with Kyrie Irving and Jason Tatum. I mean, this is the kind of stuff that you can learn in college because Zion Williamson is the guy getting all the attention. I understand if I'm Barrett, I'm saying, hey, I'm pretty good too, and I want these shots and I want this attention.
Did you see that Syracuse kid take that charge?
What kind of crazy person is he? You can't take a charge?
Look at that.
Oh, my God.
All right.
Oh, that's whiplash. Look at him. Oh, my gosh.
That right there is a fly around an elephant's tail.
Do the Lakers need LeBron to rush back?
They lost at home the other day to the Cleveland Cavaliers, and while I would tell you that there is no reason to ever regular season panic, losing at home to the Cavs, who are actively trying to lose, is a damning indictment of this roster that's built around LeBron that can't do much of anything if LeBron's not there. He is vital. We know how valuable he is. He shows us when he's playing, and he shows us when he's not. But this Laker team can't go anywhere unless that player is healthy, and you got to get him to maximum healthy, even if it means throwing away this season. You can't rush him back.
The crazy thing, Dan, when he got hurt on Christmas Day, George Sedano and I went through the entire Lakers schedule movement coming up. We said, the next 11 games, a lot of them are actually winnable. You got the Knicks, you got the Cavs, you got the Bulls, you got the Kings twice. They should be fine. And now we're sitting here and asking, when can he get back? Let me tell you something. If he doesn't get back soon, the schedule turns really ugly. After the Chicago game on Tuesday, 18 of his next 21 games, the Lakers' next 21 games, are extremely losable games. Extremely losable games. And so LeBron doesn't get back soon. You're looking at a slide that could push them further and further down the Western Conference standings.
If you don't understand how LeBron James carries people, listen to Richard Jefferson talking about the finals victory against the Warriors. LeBron with the block at the end of the game on Andre Iguodala, and then Kyrie Irving makes a shot. This is what Richard Jefferson had to tell the Players Tribune.
And so we make a timeout, we make a sub, I check into the game, and at first I'm in the strong side corner where Kyrie shot the ball. So Bron clears me out, and I was like, good, because I want no part of this, right? So they clear me out. They take me to the other, I go to the other corner, right? And so my thing in the corner, I'm like, okay, well, when this shot goes up, go for the offensive rebound. If you don't think you get it, you got to bust your back. Like, that's my process. Like, I tell you, I'm thinking all this stuff and what I need to do. Shot goes up, and I just stand there. I don't go offensive rebound. I don't get back. I'm just like, oh, he's shooting a three. Oh, that went in. Like again, these are like the same reactions that fans have and that the media has. That's the same reaction we have. Like, I see Kyrie Irving dribbling over there, and I'm like, okay, Kai. I was like, first of all, they cleared me out, and I was like, thank God, because if my man went to go double and they threw the ball, I don't know what the I was going to do. I might have made a shot. I might have dunked it. I might have dribbled off my foot. I don't know.
I remind you as well, by the way, that he was in that game and in that uniform because of the veteran leadership that the Cavs needed in critical moments. Somebody who would be composed and know exactly what they were doing.
A steadying force.
Hey, LeBron, take as much time as you need, buddy. I know that has been tough on you, but I'm telling you something. If I were you, I'd take the rest of this season off, maybe next season too. You know what I mean? Did you enjoy that game, the LA Rams that you went to, and you got a lot of attention there? Well, you know, you got to do that every week. You know, look for places to go. Screw the basketball for the time. And enjoy life, LeBron. Are you here for Iman Chumper attempting to go into the Blazers locker room to confront Jusik Nurkić?
What is that all about? This is exciting. This is the reason. You're not excited about this? This is exactly the way these foreign players who can have trouble breaking through in America because their English is shaky and because we won't make Vladimir Guerrero and Miguel Cabrera stars if they don't speak the English language well enough. In his second language, this dude said of Iman Chumper when Iman Chumper was outside the locker room, he tells reporters, I'm not interested in anything going on with a player who's that close to retirement. I'm not paying him any mind. And as if that weren't bad enough, this is the son of a 400-pound Bosnian police riot cop. You do not want to mess with this person.
Look, beyond not wanting to mess with this person, let's just assume that Iman Shumpert is right. He said, hey, I just wanted to talk to him. What are you going to tell him? Hey, I don't like your hard screens. Could you stop? What do you think he's going to say? Oh, you know what? I didn't realize I hurt you that bad. I'll look forward to doing things differently in the future. Come on.
He's that? He's almost 400 pounds?
Uh-oh, here comes the fat joke. Go ahead.
He's almost as thick as you.
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Should we judge Adam Gase for his awkward press conference?
This was a little bit startling to watch. Usually when there's an introductory press conference, it's real easy. You give off that new coach smell. You talk about getting low and being aggressive and changing the culture, and you're fine. But when you sit down like this and you look the way Adam Gase does, first of all, jarring. Doesn't look like a Wonder Boy without that baseball cap. And then he's just looking around the room in a way that the internet is making fun of today. I mean, literally no one cared about the Jets press conference outside of Jets headquarters until he did this. And then the entire internet started making fun of him because we've never seen something like this in an introductory press conference. What is this?
Isn't the irony that he could have said anything? He could have given us the secret of life and we would not care today because we're just all fixated on his eyes. And you know what, Adam Gase? I know how it feels for people to be fixated on your eyes. A couple months ago, I was on Highly Questionable. I had a really bad eczema attack under my eyes. It was really itchy and swollen and everything. And everybody on the internet didn't care about the amazing information, the basketball genius I gave you, the football insight I gave you. No, everyone's fixated on, Amin, was he out on South Beach real late last night? Hey, Amin, maybe you want to put the bottle down. I have eczema, damn it.
I tell you one, that was pretty bad, but I know a guy who got off to a worse start.
No, you do not. No, you do not.
Yeah.
He does.
Can I have
that?
Look at the marbles. Oh.
Yes, all the marbles.
Go for it. Go, I mean, go. Now is it time. Go. He got too close to the edge.
This is the biggest reach you guys have ever done to play that video.
That is correct. Go to commercial.
Now there is eczema in that water.
That's right. So much eczema. Is that contagious? Can you get it by being in the water? No one will fall in that water because no one ever falls on the very first thing.
Coming up next on Highly Questionable.
Careful with that guy in the back. Careful. Somebody tell him there's a guy. Oh. The Oilers of Edmonton, not of Venezuela.
Caracas.
Was the goal worth it going off of Garland's?
Just got a job as all the
more than anyone at this table. Do you question?
In a world where you give us topics and events, we question them.
It's pretty good.
Do you question if this inbounds play will cash on?
I am told that Wright State and Northern Kentucky have a fierce rivalry, and Northern Kentucky in this game is up by 3 late. What do we have?
30 and 14.
What is this line about?
Oh, wow. Oh, I like it already.
Yes.
Football play. That's right.
Does it work?
Yeah.
It does work?
I mean, did that have any? What?
Oh,
wait a second.
There's no disputing that the play worked. They dribbled out the clock, basically. They took their free throws with 2 seconds left, and they felt smarter than the other guys, which is an added bonus. But no, that will not catch on. It works one time and only one time.
I loved it, man. I like how they lined up. I wanted to see some hot routes. I wanted to see some audibles there. There's so many more wrinkles you could do with this, Dan.
I wanted to see one of the guys getting tackled.
Yes, so did I. So did I. I wanted to see that, too. That's the way you solved that. Jam them at the line.
Do you question the body language of the goalkeeper in the sixth category of English soccer?
The sixth category of English soccer?
Premier League, first division, second division, third division, fourth, sixth division?
The sixth division. Let's see what we have here.
Jamie Stock with the header.
It was Jamie Stock putting back.
Careful with that guy in the back. Careful. Somebody tell him there's a guy. Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, it's yes.
Hold on a second. I want to go back here. Watch how quickly his head drops when he realizes the mistake he's made. Watch. He doesn't even chase the play. He's like, oh, no, I'm a failure. Look. Oh! I am so ashamed.
You know what my favorite part is? That the offensive player, Mullern, I believe is his name, before he actually strikes, he's scratching his nose as if to play off. That's the move.
You scratch your nose. Don't mind me.
Innocent bystander.
Just hanging out here in a blue uniform behind you to take all of your grace.
Maybe he was just sad because he's playing sixth category English soccer. You know, how low can you get? You know what I mean?
Is there a seventh category?
He looks up and says, I got to climb on that mountain there. You'll never be able to make
it. Never get into the Premier League.
If there's a seventh category, he's on his way.
Do you question if this goal was worth it?
We're going out to a game involving the Oilers, Poppy. Do you know in hockey? He doesn't know a lot about hockey. Do you know where the Oilers are from? Do you know?
The Oilers? Sure. They're from... I don't know, was it Venezuela maybe?
Okay, they don't have hockey in Venezuela.
The Caracas Oilers.
All right, let's check in here with a recent game involving the Oilers of Edmonton, not of Venezuela.
Caracas.
Was the goal worth it going off of Garland's face here? Is it the side of his face? Oh, is there going to be a lot of blood here? Is this going to be disgusting? This is going to be disgusting, right? That's a slap shot from far away. Yeah, you need the goalie to make a save there. You need him to make a save. Yes. No, it is not worth it for the Oilers of Venezuela.
Well, for the Coyotes. By the way, I like how people say Coyotes, but there are people in Arizona called the Coyotes.
Ow.
Makes me feel like I'm in the Old West, the Coyotes. Yeah, that's disgusting.
Oh, man.
That about concludes our commentary on that.
Highly questionable. It's broadcast from the Clevelander Hotel on beautiful South Beach, Miami. Time to play the game that is suspicious about the way Mayo move. See? Oh, no.
There is no way that the audience understood that he just said the word Mayo. You tell us what's on television tonight. We tell you if we're intrigued.
Tonight on NBA League Pass, Warriors and Nuggets.
We've got a Jokic-Plumlee situation where you can't stop the Nuggets. They've got the best record in the sport. Amin was asked earlier this year, who is the second-place team to the Warriors? He said the Utah Jazz. If he had said the Denver Nuggets, he would look brilliant. But he said the Utah Jazz, so he doesn't. Let's check out this pick and roll between two fives. Plumlee and Jokic, what are you going to do? Yeah.
That's nice.
That is nice.
You know, it's almost as nice as the way you pronounce Nikola Jokic's name. Jokic, not Jokic, and not Jerkic.
This might be viewed as a potential statement game for only one of the teams. Amin, are you intrigued?
Of course. I'm surprised this is on League Pass. This is two of the best teams in the league
Bobby, are you intrigued?
Oh, see, I'm very intrigued. You mean to tell me that after all these weeks we were worrying about the Warriors, you know, not being on first place? If they win tonight, you know, they're going to be back on first place?
That's right.
Can't believe that.
That's right. The big surprise, Nuggets are just barely ahead of a Warriors team that looks dysfunctional.
Tonight at 3 a.m. on ESPN2, the Australian Open.
3 a.m. in the event that you're going to the bathroom because you're an old person and you go to the bathroom at 3 a.m. We go out to the Australian Open here. They'll check in with a ball boy. What's happening here with a coin toss? Oh!
Really?
Oh!
Really? There,
yeah! A little Michael Jackson!
No.
What? No?
He's trying to do a little Michael Jackson.
He's trying.
He's failing miserably.
Okay. Well, come on. So judgmental.
Yes.
Amin, are you intrigued?
I'm very intrigued. As you know, Dan, I'm a huge tennis fan. I'm also a huge fan of being up at 3 in the morning, particularly in Miami.
Poppy, are you intrigued?
Oh, see, I'm very intrigued. You know, that's a good ball boy, but that's not my favorite ball boy. This is my favorite ball boy.
What do we have here?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, here he is, right here. Yeah, here you go.
I love this. Yeah.
Yeah. The sound, he's slightly less confident than the other ball boy.
Oh, man.
Slightly less confident.
I like how a man turns around slowly. Like, what was that sound, man? What's going on back there?
Tonight on USA, Temptation Island.
Oh, this show here was, I don't want to say popular, but it was around from 2001 to 2003. And now we've got a reboot situation. Temptation Island, Poppy.
Oh,
yes, oh, my father's interested in Temptation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Four couples are at a...
I'm done.
Temptation Island.
I could have gone another 16 years without watching that. Amin, are you intrigued?
I am intrigued because I want to know. There's one guy in the singles with the glasses on. I said, he looks like he's going to be the one single guy who's not going to hook up with anybody.
Poppy, are you intrigued?
Oh, see, I'm very intrigued. Temptation Island, you know, but my Temptation Island won't have people on it. They will have, you know, hamburger, hot dogs, french fries, shakes, pizza,
delicious.
Chili.
Okay.
I'm telling you, cookies.
All right.
I'm telling you, I've got all kind of stuff, you know what I mean? Cheese. I'm telling you, crackers, chicken nuggets, you know what I mean? Oh, man, I'm telling you something. I'm telling you what else I have. Apple pie a la mode, you know, ice cream too, all kind of ice cream, you know, the whole ball of wax. That's what I love.
Tonight on MTV, Lindsay Lohan's Beach Club.
Oh, this is an abomination. You want to hear and see how Lindsay Lohan interacts with her employees? I guess it doesn't go well.
Okay.
I mean, are you intrigued?
Hell no. What's wrong with her, man? What's wrong with her voice?
What's wrong? Just all of it. Poppy, are you intrigued?
Oh, see, I'm very intrigued. But listen, something tells me that her acting career is not going very well so far.
You know what tells
I mean?
Him that.
I think that she's speaking. Yeah,
she's speaking from America. Very few options. Lindsay Lohan's Beach Club is the only offer available.
That's all the time we have for today. Thank you for watching.
South Beach Sessions. Download it if you want a long-form interview with Adam McKay, the director, the comedian, the guy who did Step Brothers, Talladega Nights, Vice. He did Kenny Powers. Let's go.
Thanks for dressing up.
I mean, seriously, dude. It's a
really?
Professional television network, man.
Ah, man.
Come on.
Guy has a purple shirt on.